You have the state's attorney's office saying he's not exonerated. He actually did commit this hoax. He's saying he's innocent and his words are true. They better get their story straight, because this is actually making a fools of all of us. This, on that fundamental level, doesn't add up. He abused the city of Chicago. He actually committed a crime here. He lied about something. And remember, the grand jury indicted him when only seeing a portion of the evidence. This looks like, because he's an actor, a person of influence, he got treated differently than anybody else.
And he was charged with 16 felonies. As you can hear, fresh outrage this morning from Chicago's Mayor Rahm Emanuel, joining local law enforcement, all furious as charges against Jussie Smollett, the actor, are dropped and his record has been sealed.
Here to react is host of CBS's Whistleblower and former Dade County Circuit Court Judge Alex Ferrer. Good morning to you, Judge Alex.
Good morning, Ainsley. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you. Tell me, what's your reaction to all of this? Last night when all of this broke, we were all, how did this happen? How did he get off with, you know, with so many people against him and the police department saying what they did in that press conference?
It's outrageous. For the benefit of viewers who don't know how things usually work like this, a person gets arrested and typically they plead not guilty, a trial date is set, and between the day of the charges being filed and the trial date, they enter into a plea and take either a jail sentence or probation with community service and a fine, or they go to trial and the jury decides whether they're guilty and a judge does whatever the judge thinks is appropriate in the case. Rarely, very rarely, a state attorney will dismiss all the charges after the person does maybe 6 months of community service. That is typically for a case where, for example, a kid goes into a Kmart and steals a few fishing lures, some minor case like that. This is not that case. In this case, Jussie Smollett, according to the state attorney's evidence that they presented to a grand jury, which charged him, as you said, with 16 felonies, totally manufactured this fraudulent attack, made it intentionally homophobic, racist, accused Trump supporters, because he knew that would outrage the community and get him all this publicity that might advance his career. And in doing that, he cost the city of Chicago probably hundreds of thousands of dollars in police man hours investigating this. 24 detectives for, I think it was about 6 weeks, investigating his crime. He gets caught. And what does Assistant State Attorney Joseph Magetz think is the appropriate punishment? We will dismiss all the charges, give you credit for 2 days of community service that you did since you were indicted, which, by the way, if you're innocent, why are you doing preemptive community service to work out a plea? And we'll just keep your $10,000 bond, which to a guy like Jussie Smollett, who gets paid millions for being on Empire, or did, it is like fining somebody $500 for costing the city hundreds of thousands of dollars. It is outrageous. And oh, by the way, he gets to expunge his record, which means there'll be no trace he was ever arrested, and his employer cannot use his arrest as a reason to terminate him. I'm sure that's the next thing coming down the pipe. Hey, 20th Century Fox, you have to hire me back. So, yes, do I think there's something wrong here? Absolutely, there's something wrong here. Anybody who knows how the system works is going to think this is flat-out corruption. Somebody made a call. Somebody who knows the state attorney or the assistant state attorney called and said, do me this favor, and we'll help you down the road. That is what I feel happened in this case.
Well, you're not the first person who has suggested it was political in nature. And to your earlier point about how the prosecutor presented to the grand jury all the evidence, prosecutors said it was very clear. The evidence was overwhelming. You got the two brothers as evidence. They told the story to the grand jury and other people. But then part of the deal, and they're even denying that there's a written down deal. But apparently, you know, Smollett does not have to admit he did anything wrong, simply because he went through community service, 16 hours, and forfeited $10,000 out of the $30,000 bail.
I mean, think about this. The ridiculous part is the kid who steals the lures would have probably got 150 community service hours. He went and did two token days before this. Did not have to stand in front of a judge and plead guilty, which most people would have to at least admit their guilt. Now he can walk around, continue maligning the Chicago Police Department, continue proclaiming that he's actually innocent when the evidence that the state attorney laid out was overwhelming. And the state attorney who granted this sweetheart deal even says now, after the outrage came out, no, we're not saying he's innocent. We stand behind the Chicago Police Department. Really? then why did you offer this deal? Yeah. I don't think it's just celebrity. Right. I really don't, because Martha Stewart was a celebrity. This guy is connected. I understand he's friends with the Obamas. And early in this case, Michelle Obama's chief of staff made a call to the state attorney and tried to get the investigation transferred at the request of Smollett's family to the FBI. That's a remarkable coincidence.
So you think that Michelle Obama should be questioned?
No, I don't know that Michelle Obama had anything to do with it. But when you're connected at that high a level, there's a lot of people who are willing to do
but
you
so
favors.
But so is Rahm Emanuel but connected at a high level. Rahm Emanuel's the mayor, and no one even told
yeah,
him.
Yeah, but you notice that Rahm Emanuel is not saying that anything about it being a fix because Michelle Obama's chief of staff right. called, and he knows that just as well
Judge.
As I do. He's very good friends with the Obamas. I did hear somebody on Shepard Smith, I wish I knew his name, an attorney yesterday say, you know what the Chicago police should do? The Chicago police should sue Jussie Smollett for the hundreds of thousands of dollars
sure.
in investigative fees. Then the truth will come out in court, or right. Jussie Smollett, an innocent man, will remarkably, out of the goodness of his heart, agree to pay back investigative costs that he didn't cause.
Yeah.
And I think that's brilliant. I think that would actually work.
Judge,
and also the FBI can investigate.
Real quick. If they were trying behind the scenes to get it out of the Chicago cops' hands and into the FBI's hands, what does that say about the Chicago FBI?
Well, it could be that a person that high up in politics may have self-friended the FBI, but it could also be that this request was made 4 days after he reported the crime. I suspect the police right from the outset knew this was BS,
okay.
and the handwriting was on the wall that they were not buying his story, and they wanted to just get it away from Chicago police and into the FBI, who may not look at it seriously. But by the way, Not just the envelope the FBI is supposedly investigating. This crime that he reported could be wire fraud because he used text messages to perpetrate the fraud. So the FBI could step in and investigate this for wire fraud. And I really think they should because okay. people every day are just losing faith in the judicial system, and it's really offensive.
Yeah, and yesterday was as offensive as any I can remember. Judge, thanks so much.
Thanks, Judge.
Always a pleasure, guys.